TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Surbhi Sharma. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Wednesday, the 25th of December. India pays tribute to former PM Vajpayee on his 95th birth anniversary. Nepal Socialist Party quits PM Oli-led government. And Christians across India, Pakistan celebrate Christmas with fervour. And now for all the details. India on Wednesday paid tributes to former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee on his 95th birth anniversary. Prime Minister Narendra Modi dedicated the launch of a groundwater management scheme, a strategic tunnel and a hospital to Vajpayee to mark the occasion. India on Wednesday paid tributes to former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee on his 95th birth anniversary. President Ramnath Kovind and Prime Minister Narendra Modi, along with other leaders, paid floral tributes to Vajpayee at his memorial in Indian capital New Delhi. Born on December 25, 1924, Vajpayee was the first leader of India's ruling Bharatiya Janata Party or BJP to be sworn in as Prime Minister. Prime Minister Modi-led government is working on several public welfare schemes named after Vajpayee. PM Modi on Wednesday in a special event dedicated the Atal Bhujal Yojana to Vajpayee, a Rs 6,000 crore scheme to improve groundwater management. He also named a strategic tunnel under Rohtang Pass after Vajpayee. The decision to construct the tunnel was taken in the year 2000 when Vajpayee was the Prime Minister.
Pani ko lekar ke Atal ji ka jo vision tha. वो विजन आज भी हमें प्रेरणा देता है. अटल जल योजना हो या फिर जल जीवन मिशन से जुड़ी गाइडलाइंस, ये 2024 तक देश के हर घर तक जल पहुंचाने के संकल्प को सिद्ध करने में एक बड़ा कदम है.
Later in the day, Prime Minister Modi unveiled a 25-feet grand statue of Atal Bihari Vajpayee opposite the Uttar Pradesh State Assembly in Lucknow City. He also laid foundation stone for proposed Atal Bihari Medical University in northern Uttar Pradesh province. Vajpayee was the moderate face of Hindu nationalism and was admired by his political foes. He is also known for ordering nuclear tests in 1998 during his second term, in a strategic masterstroke to blunt Pakistan's nuclear ambitions. Moving on, the Indian diaspora has been holding rallies across the US in support of India's new citizenship law, which paves way to Indian citizenship for persecuted non-Muslim communities who settled in the country before 2015. The Citizenship Amendment Act has also faced protests across India for not including Muslims.
The Indian diaspora in the US has been holding rallies in different cities, including Seattle, Austin, and Houston, in support of India's Citizenship Amendment Act, or CAA, which was passed earlier this month. The organizers of the rallies belonging to different organizations said they aim to dispel the misinformation and myths surrounding the legislation due to protests in several parts of India over fears that the law is anti-Muslim. The religion-based citizenship law will pave way to Indian citizenship to persecuted non-Muslim communities from Pakistan, Afghanistan and Bangladesh who have settled in India before 2015. While speaking on ongoing protests against the Citizenship Amendment Act in an interview to ANI News Agency, India's Interior Minister Amit Shah on Tuesday said there might have been some communication gap on the part of the government in reaching out to people. He denied the charges of religious bias.
कुछ तो खामी रही होगी, मुझे स्वीकारने में कोई तकलीफ नहीं है, परंतु पार्लियामेंट का मेरा भाषण उठाकर देख लीजिए, इसमें मैंने ये सारी स्पष्टताएं करी है कि इसी से किसी भी अल्पसंख्यक की नागरिकता जाने का सवाल नहीं, किसी की भी जाने का सवाल नहीं, क्योंकि ये बिल में किसी की नागरिकता लेने का कोई प्रावधान ही नहीं है।
India's ruling Bharatiya Janata Party has accused opposition parties for spreading lies which have led to protests across India against the citizenship law. There were also reports of violence during clashes between police and protesters in some parts of the country in the past 2 weeks.
In news from Pakistan, after the US State Department took a unilateral and arbitrary decision of keeping Pakistan in its 2019 annual blacklist for religious freedom violations, Islamabad has categorically rejected the move. The country was kept in the list for a second consecutive year.
Pakistan's foreign ministry on Tuesday rejected the unilateral and arbitrary designation by the US in its annual religious freedom report. Pakistan's foreign ministry spokesperson Aisha Farooqi tweeted a press release stating that the designation by the US was not only detached from the ground realities of Pakistan but also raises questions on the credibility and transparency of the entire exercise. The US State Department had identified Pakistan as a country of particular concern for having engaged in or tolerated systematic, ongoing and egregious violations of religious freedom. Activists have long blamed Pakistan for discriminating against its minorities, which is manifested in various forms against Pakistani Hindus, Christians, Sikhs and also Ahmadiyyas and Shia Muslims. Human rights defenders have long blamed the draconian blasphemy laws are exploited by religious extremists as well as ordinary Pakistanis to settle personal scores against minorities.
It is from Afghanistan. Afghanistan's incumbent president Ashraf Ghani's main contender in September's presidential poll, Chief Executive Abdullah Abdullah, has filed over 4,000 complaints over the preliminary vote results. Abdullah declared the outcome as illegitimate after Ghani secured more votes.
Afghanistan's Chief Executive Officer Abdullah Abdullah, the main challenger of incumbent president Ashraf Ghani, has filed over 4,000 complaints over the preliminary presidential election results. The Independent Electoral Complaints Commission Office in the country has said it will review the complaints with full attention and high transparency. The commission will share the results back with Independent Election Commission or IEC within next 5 weeks. The poll body announced the preliminary election results on December 22nd, in which President Ghani secured the highest votes with 50.64% and Abdullah got 39.52% votes. Ghani has welcomed the result and said the country is now on the right path towards prosperity and development and promised to serve the Afghans equally.
The incumbent government of Nepal under Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli is at stake, as ministers from the Socialist Party have decided to walk out, citing the failure in implementation of a two-point agreement that the two sides had signed.
Minister Upendra Yadav and Mohammad Ishtiaq Rai from Nepal's Socialist Party on Tuesday resigned from Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli-led government, citing the failure in implementation of a two-point agreement that the two sides had signed earlier. Party chair Upendra Yadav, who was appointed as the deputy prime minister in the current government, issuing a release on Tuesday, said that he is resigning on moral grounds as the government has backtracked from its two-point agreement with his party. Yadav, who also assumed portfolio of the Ministry of Law, Justice and Parliamentary Affairs, further said he was in the December 23rd meeting of the Council of Ministers, where the proposal of the Constitution Amendment was rejected once again. The Federal Socialist Party had joined the government on the condition of amending the Constitution for the rights of Madhesis. The Socialist Party has a total of 17 lawmakers, and the incumbent government of Oli has a clear-cut two-third majority with 191 lawmakers in its support.
More news from Nepal. Police in Nepal has been proving over 120 Chinese nationals arrested earlier this week for involvement in cyber fraud. The suspects have been remanded to a 5-day police custody.
A total of 122 Chinese nationals who were arrested from different locations in Nepal's capital Kathmandu on Monday for involvement in cyber fraud have been remanded to police custody for 5 days, local media said on Tuesday. Police who have confiscated hundreds of laptops, desktop computers, mobile phones and SIM cards from the detained Chinese nationals doubt that all those arrested were involved in criminal activities, but said it is too early to come to any conclusion. The Chinese national were detained after a coordinate move was carried out by different police bodies and the Central Investigation Bureau. In September, 5 Chinese nationals were arrested for using cloned debit cards to breach the processing system of banks and withdraw cash amounting to millions of rupees from different cash dispensers in Kathmandu. Police had then confiscated more than 100 forged Visa debit cards, some authentic Visa cards, mobile phones, a laptop and a data card from them.
Christians across India and Pakistan celebrated Christmas with fervor and gaiety on Wednesday. The celebrations began after midnight mass in churches, marking the birth of Jesus Christ.
Christian devotees across India attended midnight mass on the occasion of Christmas festival on Wednesday. India's tourist hub of Goa was seen to be the most festive as locals as well as tourists crowded ancient churches across the city and listened to the Gospels in Konkani language on the occasion. People on Christmas throng illuminated and decorated churches where they pray, listen to carols and sermons and light candles to mark the festival.
We're not Catholics ourselves. We've been looking forward to seeing this service here at the Immaculate Conception Church. And because we are followers of Jesus Christ, we understood many parts of the gospel because we heard the names, even though it was in the local Konkani language. And it was great to see how many people came here to celebrate the mass at midnight. So I really enjoyed it. It was a great experience.
Priests in southern Chennai also made the sermons in local Tamil language on Christmas. It is believed that the festival brings the opportunity for devotees to grow spiritually towards Jesus Christ.
As we celebrate this day as birth of Christ, His birth has brought to this world hope, joy, peace and equality.
While celebrations in India continued on a large scale, Christians in neighboring Pakistan also attended special prayers to mark the occasion. The worshippers belonging to the tiny Christian community in Karachi city passed through security gates before they were allowed to enter the churches. December 25th is a public holiday in Pakistan not because of Christmas, but because it is the birthday of Qaid Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah, the founder of the country.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. India pays tribute to former PM Vajpayee on his 95th birth anniversary. Nepal's Socialist Party quits PM Oli-led government. And Christians across India and Pakistan celebrate Christmas with fervor. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.